Teddy Roosevelt said, "The more you know about the past, the better you are prepared for the future." That's why the Morgan Corp of today stays connected to the Morgan Landscape Company of days past. A strong history makes for a bright future. That history starts in 1945. World War II was over, the soldiers were home, and the greatest generation was about to get to work. Ladson Columbus Morgan, known as Slim to most, was an Army veteran, a respected young man in the community. He was one of those guys that could learn anything he had to, and then do it in order to get the job done. Mr. Morgan bought some better machinery and got pretty good at it, even if he wasn't sure what he bought.
Mr. Morgan told me right after the war, he bought a bulldozer in a crate in Nashville, Tennessee, and he borrowed a truck and went up there and they put this crate up on the trailer, and he started home, and he said, "You know, I'd never seen the thing." So we got a crowbar and pulled on the side of the road and uncrated it.
I knew Ladson very well. He was a contractor here. He had front-end loaders. He did housework and lots and stuff like this for the house building. And Stuart revered him. He thought a lot of him, and he went on to carry it to another level, of course.
Being one of the only bulldozers in town got him plenty of work. See, if you wanted to build a foundation, you needed to call the Morgan Landscape Company first.
I'll say that when Ladson Morgan, when I talked to him towards his later years in life, he talked about he never saw how far Morgan could go, and he was very impressed, you know, with where it is now. And then when I talked to my dad, and when he bought it in 71, he says, "You know, I knew we were going to do great things, but you don't know how far it's going to go."
George and Stuart Johnson found themselves with Mr. Morgan one Sunday morning in the pines of South Carolina. They needed the area cleared out so a lake could be created there. It was there that Mr. Morgan shared his future plans for the Morgan Landscape Company with the Johnson brothers. This was a pivotal moment for these men who had developed a friendship. It was time to pass the torch of the Morgan legacy.
One day we were where the Carolina Country Club now is, the 18th Green, and he would leave his equipment on the weekends. George was his lawyer, and we could play with it. And when playing, I mean push up stumps and stuff. We had always loved equipment. He told me he was going to sell the company. That was in the spring of 70.
A friendship had grown between Stuart and Ladson, so that it was also a very personal decision to hold on to the Morgan name, because he did have a lot of respect for Mr. Morgan, for what he had built. He himself wanted to follow in those same footsteps to have a long-term company that he could build.
And for him to maintain the name, so many people come in and want to take over and they want to put their name on the headlights, but he kept Morgan, and I always thought that was a classy thing to do. And Ladson Morgan will never forget it. And every time I saw him after that, he would make a comment about, "He kept my name."
And so began the company that always strives for excellence. And 75 years later, still believes that good people are the key to good business. The Johnson family took over, but they kept the name. After all, everyone knew what Morgan on the side of the truck stood for: taking care of the customer, and then taking care of business. Over the next few years, they worked tirelessly to build on what Mr. Morgan created, usually putting in over 80 hours a week. It was a pace that could not be sustained. But Morgan Corp was faced with the challenge of growing as a site development company, yet sustained the values of integrity and accountability that Mr. Morgan and the Johnsons had built. They couldn't bid on the bigger jobs with bigger pay, because they didn't have the workers who could run it. Hence, the unparalleled shift to hire and invest in good people became part of Morgan Corp culture.
If you hire good people, they find good people. And the secret is to hire good people and to hire somebody better than you are.
And I think it all stems from always searching for more good people. And if you have an employee that is a good person and a good employee, the likelihood that they hang out with or have family members that are similar to them is good, is high.
I think Tim led by example, and he surrounded himself with smart people that were willing to go the distance with him.
to keep the ship upright and sailing in the same direction that the core people of our company agree with and push on to make this company a bigger and better, more employees and spread out a little bit larger than what we are right now. And back in the day, we were 10 or 15 in the 70s, and now we're up to 400 plus. I mean, that says a lot.
Tim Halligan and Bob Mine, they set a high standard because they did things the right way. They wanted to do things the right way, and they treated people well. And so that set the standard for the rest of us that would come after.
George and Stuart now had over a decade of experience running the business and a team of sharp minds around them. They were ready for Morgan Corp to make the jump. And it did in the mid-80s with golf and gold. Debadoo Colony is a private golf course development on the coast. Morgan Corp had 45 employees when it started that job. And nearly a year later, when it was complete, over 200 people were on the payroll. Along with the golf course project came the gold mine, as employees called it. A mine in Ridgeway needed work done. This job became the largest job in the company's history.
When I came in 84, our projects ran from about 25,000 to about 250,000. And then in 85, I believe it was, we started a Debadoo Colony Club and we did our golf course there. And it was, I think it paved the way for us moving to bigger projects because there was a lot of detail involved. And then in 88, we got the Ridgeway Gold Mine project, which was $4.6 million contract.
As always, Morgan Corp didn't just want to work in the community. We wanted to be in the community. We realized new offices needed to be built and staffed to better serve the area.
Stuart always had a vision of growing the company, but growing the company successfully and growing it at a pace that was sustainable.
We continue to grow geographically with a work area as far west as Texas and as far north as West Virginia. We grow relationally with new customers and our employees every day.
It's our goal to help the young people that we bring in understand the industry and to find their own place. And you know, the case at Morgan Corp is a whole lot of them decide to stay for an awful long time.
If we want to continue to do what we do, we've got to train people. You got to take people with good attitudes and with good work ethic, and you've got to teach them how to run a dozer. You got to teach them how to run a motor grader. You got to teach them how to run equipment.
Thanks to our industry partners' high respect of Morgan Corp and business reputation, we have opened offices in Charlotte, North Carolina and Savannah, Georgia.
The way we got started in Charlotte, Dean Dillman, I know we'll forget this, they needed help up there. So that's when Jay went up there.
He was asked to go to Charlotte. It was about a 30-second conversation and says, do you want to move to Charlotte? Do you want to be estimator? See you on Tuesday kind of scenario.
But let me tell you, you just don't walk into a community, get the job, because people don't know, might not know you, they know you by reputation. But you also got to prove yourself. Savannah met Simon and his team down there doing an absolutely wonderful job.
Long-term relationships have really been impactful. The Vogel project began with a relationship that Charlotte started with Cliffside, and that was with Shaw. Now it was in 2006. And we developed that relationships and had a great project with them. And then the nuclear revitalization started to happen.
In our industry, there's a lot of people out there that do the same thing. If you want a good company that stands for all the, and we can talk about social contract too, but you know, we have a reputation, we work hard, we do the right thing at the right time, and we have great advertisement, and that's part of our selling.
As technology advances in society, Morgan Corp stays current as a business to better serve our customers as well as our employees. Whether it's ensuring job accuracy or committing to a culture of safety, we continue to invest in our Morgan Corp family by providing state-of-the-art equipment and comprehensive training.
Technology has been our agent for change. It has driven us into far more great opportunities with the GPS, with the drones, and how we train individuals. Now we have simulators. We have a simulator that we could roll in this room with us today.
I think training and education is a huge priority here at Morgan Corp. I mean, we We've invested a lot of time, money, and effort into our training program for our management team and for our craft team.
We believe that long term, we'll be better off as a company if we build those skill sets, because then we have the quality control over what those skill sets are and what we want these people to know. And so the only way to do that is training.
With so many things going on today, it would be easy to forget about tomorrow. But Morgan Corp continues to plan for a bright future with a scholarship fund to make sure future leaders are being prepared today. This is one of the ways we give back to our Morgan Corp family who have sacrificed for Morgan Corp's success.
Morgan has a scholarship fund where we contribute to it every year, and we want to pay for the education of its employees' children in the future.
Offices have changed, equipment has improved, and technology has revolutionized. But one thing remains the same: our values. From the greatest generation to the 21st century, Morgan Corp continues to find great people and build strong relationships. And a legacy that's built on 75 years of integrity, family, and hard work will do well for many years to come.
The way that anybody can carry Morgan's legacy forward, just like Stuart carried Mr. Morgan's legacy forward, we're carrying the Johnson family's legacy forward. How do you carry that forward? Is you stay true to the things that have made us the company that we are.
We will always continue to grow. I think to have a vibrant business, you have to continue growth in developing people.
You know, in 75 years for a company to still be in business, I'm gonna brag a little here, but to still be in business and in the construction business and in the grading business is almost unheard of. But Morgan is still here, and it's more viable today than it was 75 years ago or when we bought it.
We wouldn't be where we are without the people that we got. Loyalty, in the short sentence that I'm gonna give you, a person who will stand by you thick and thin. When the ox is in the ditch and is stuck, they'll get in there with you and help you.
I think once you embrace the social contract, the trust is easy. The hard part is the building of the jobs and the development of people. And that's something that we gotta start today, and we will continue for the next 75 years, because that's our future.